Christmas 2005, I woke up Christmas morning with my three siblings in the same room, two brothers and one sister, and at the end of our stockings, there's these wooden swords from Lord of the Rings. Now, I was a little boy, so a wooden sword, that's just fun. The imaginations that were going through my head, the things I was picturing to do with that, painting it, fighting with it, going outside and pretending I was Aragorn, I was really excited. And it's something that like really affected my mood. And all throughout the day, through our huge breakfast, all the presents, and our huge dinner at the end of the day, I couldn't help but thinking of the sword. And that's just a really clear example of the excitement of Christmas and what you do. Christmas is a huge example of something that affects your mood and what can make you look at things differently, either happy or sad, stressed out, excited. It's huge. But on this episode of This American Life, we're gonna kind of cut back. We're gonna be talking about things that affect you more on a day-to-day basis. Small, little, tiny things. It gives you more of a personal feeling. Now, when you think about things that affect your attitude, sometimes it can be limitless. Tiny little things can happen that make you happy. Tiny little things that make you mad. Or there's those big, big things that flip your world upside down, and either it's the best thing that's ever happened, or it's the worst. It's very different how it all comes together. And with this episode, we're really cutting back down on a real personal level. We're going to be introducing a couple people who have examples of things that affect them. We have some music, school, and a funny one, video games actually. Things that affect your attitude, and we're going to be discovering in this life, our lives in America, what affects our attitudes and how that plays into our lives from a day to day, or even sometimes a lifetime. And we're going to see how all that plays out. What's something that affects your mood on a day-to-day or even minute-to-minute basis?
I'd say music is probably one of the biggest things that affects my day-to-day mood. Just because it really, every song gives off its own feeling, its own tune that just makes you want to dance around or be mad, be sad, all that sort of stuff.
What about music specifically, like, affects your attitude?
Well, I could get into all the complicated keys and chords of a song that could vary slightly and completely change the mood of the entire song, but really, a general description is just every song has its own feeling, its own tone, and just really gives off its own mood. And that's why music really changes my day.
It's a happy or kind of joyful song that just makes you kind of feel better about what's going on.
Well, I have a lot of songs for that, but one of my specific genres or bands is Sublime, and they play mostly reggae music, and it's just so happy, and there's the syncopated rhythm, which is offbeat, and it just cheers my day up and just makes everything brighter, you know what I mean?
Classical
music is just, it's the root of music, it's all, it's all that stuff, and it's so boring. Oh my god, classical music. I fall asleep every time I can. can't listen to it.
What type of music like makes you mad or lets you like vent all your pent up anger?
Oh my gosh, heavy metal music, of course. The whole Day to Remember, the hard rock, the I want to kill someone. That's exactly it. Hello? Someone killed my dog? No, not Susie. I gotta go. No.
What about love songs? That whole genre, the whole sappy stuff. What is that all about?
Well, as you know, in Fitchburg here, there is a ratio of, 7 to 3 girls to guys? I am a sucker for girls, and when they walk by me, I am just like, oh my god. And you know what? The perfect music to describe that is love songs. I mean, the Beatles, classic, stuff like that. Just really bring out the mood in the girl walking by. Yeah.
What music gets you like pumping? Like, what does that do to you? Like that, all that jazzed up, crazy, fun music.
When I listen to dance music while I work out, oh, it just makes me, you know, do the extra 10, you know, sets, that kind of thing. It just really gets me into the mood to work out. But and then there's the other kind of pumped up. You know, you're at the club, you know, with all your buds, and that song comes on, and you're like, oh my god, this is my song, and you scream. Not really. But, yeah, so this song comes on, you just start dancing, you gotta get it out. That's what pumped up is.
So what affects your mood? What changes your attitude, the way you look at things from a day-to-day, like, kind of basis as you're going through the day?
Well, I'd have to say school and everything that's involved with school.
What specifically changes your mood with school? What affects that?
Well, the workload, the classes, if the work takes a lot of time. So I guess that would mean time you have to put into the classes, the work,
Is there a specific subject that you like more than others? Like, just some subjects you like and others that you just can't stand?
Well, there are classes I just can't stand, but for the most part, every class is so-so for me.
Not really every class you don't like?
Yep, well, it's not necessarily don't like, it's just you just go through the movie.
Oh, that makes sense. Just the workload, it's all a lot of work. Okay. In school, there's obviously a lot of people involved. There's a lot of teachers, students, faculty. Do different teachers affect your moods?
Yes, different teachers can definitely affect one's mood in school. This can be because you can have two teachers to teach the same class. And one teacher might be harder than another teacher, or you just for some reason might like one teacher better than another. So you could have two classes, and one class you get a good grade. If you had the same class with the other teacher, you'd have a bad grade, which would definitely affect your mood.
Yeah.
And as for friends and stuff, having friends in your class is definitely affects your mood. Just knowing people in the class, having people you can ask about work.
Now, have you ever gotten like a surprise workload when you're just like, whoa, I didn't know I had that. Has that ever happened to you?
Yeah, man, it happens all the time. It's like you just get like your first shock that like you had to work, and then you're just like you get really pissed off that you have all this extra work. It's bearing down on you. Sometimes it gets thrown at you at the very last minute, so you just have to scramble to get it done, and it's very tiresome.
Hey man, how's it going?
Pretty good, you?
I'm doing great. Do you want the rabbit hole tonight, man?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. It's been a long week.
Yeah, I know. It'll be good.
Yeah, it should be. Here, there's a great concert going on.
Yeah.
This wasn't on the syllabus, but I need you guys to do a reading response and post it on Blackboard by tonight.
Oh, there goes my night. Guess I'm not going out. No concert tonight.
Man. I don't know. Maybe I might just skip it. I don't know.
Dang it. That's a lot of work.
Yeah, right? She just gives us all this homework all the time.
Dang it.
It took me 2 hours to get chapters 2 and 3 done.
2 and 3? Dude, we were supposed to do 4 and 5.
Wait, what?
Dude, are you serious? You have to do oh man, dude, that's due by tomorrow night, dude.
Shoot. Oh man, I'm not gonna be able to go out like I had planned. Like, when did she tell us it was 4 and 5? I thought it was 2 and 3.
She updated it last night on Blackboard.
Oh man, I haven't been on Blackboard yet. I think I should check. Give me the look.
Alright, sorry man. Hopefully you can do it. Sorry about that, dude.
Hours more.
What about school, like, just makes you feel good? Like, what can happen in school that just makes you just, like, on cloud nine?
Well, one thing is no homework. But an even better thing is class getting out early.
Hey man, I thought you got out in like 30 minutes.
Nah, where have you been? She said class gets out in under half hour. She's letting us out a half hour early.
Half hour early? That's a good deal. Man, you wanna go get you a bite to eat?
Yeah, let's go.
So school in general, what's your perspective? Is it important? Is it kind of just extra things to do? What does school to you?
Well, school is important, and it's important that everyone goes to school. A lot of the times, it does just feel like you're going through the motions, and it's like, schoolwork, and why do I need to do this? This isn't going to be important. But in the end, it all pays off, and yeah.
So, what affects your attitude?
I would say hobbies affects my attitude most. Just something to help me relax, help me calm down. Sometimes it doesn't exactly help, but it is always nice to just chill and have something fun to do. And probably one of my favorite hobbies is to just sit down and play a good video game.
So you said video games. Video games seem kind of mundane and almost mind-numbing. How does that, like, make you feel better?
They can be mundane and numbing sometimes, but it's just nice to be able to just, like, focus your mind on one thing. It's like when you watch a good movie, like, you just get to get lost in the plot and everything. It's the same thing with a video game, except it's interactive, and you get to have fun and do it yourself instead of watching someone else do it.
So, the video games is a very broad subject. You want to explain, like, the different types of games and, like, the different aspects and what makes you feel better?
Well, there's just, like, a lot of genres of games that depends on my mood to play and stuff. There's always, like, a shooter game, which really you just get to run around and kill as many people as you really like. It's something that's fun. It can get your stress out of playing and do something. It pulls a lot of just, like, speed, and you just have to really, really, like, pay attention, and it just gets your mind off everything. They're just fun to play, and you can a lot of times just, like, play with other friends and just stuff like that.
Crap.
Ugh. 15 kill streak, oh my gosh. That's crazy. That was terrible. Another genre would be, like, a strategy game, which you can just kind of put your mind to it, and you can play as a team instead of just, like, being a lonely wolf. You can just rely on your teammates and not just rely on yourself to play. It's fun. It's a genre that holds a lot of pieces and, like, aspects to it that other genres wouldn't hold. Matt, can you go bottom? We need some help down there. They're pushing real hard. John, go help Matt. I think I can deal with these two. Okay, sweet. Another genre would be something like a button mashing game, which is just those fun games like Super Smash Bros. Not really any point to it, but you just get to hit some people all the time. And it's games like that, you just play with friends, you have a great time. It's just really fun. And they're always a great time to play. Another thing would be like an adventure game, which has like a long storyline, something like Kingdom Hearts, Final Fantasy, Ratchet and Clank, Jack and Daxter, just games that can take you hours and hours to beat. It's fun to put your mind to it and to just try to play, and it takes days and days of work, and it's like reading a book. It just takes a while. You get enthralled in the story, and you just want to keep playing. Really lasts if you get interested and involved in the game.
The Tiger Septim Hotel is a nice place. What are you looking for? Who finds Smith's outhouse?
Another type of games would be like interactive games, like Guitar Hero. You get to stand there and just like play the game, and you just like get to do it yourself, and it's like a fun little like challenge to beat it and to get like better and better at it, to play on harder difficulties. It's just like challenge yourself, and it's just cool to be able to do that.
Like you're pulling away socially when you play like video games by yourself?
Sometimes you will feel like that. You'll just want to you'll be like in your room just playing video games by yourself, which is sometimes nice to be able to just pull off and to be able to get away from everyone and from like the stress of life and everything. But on the other hand, it can be the exact opposite, is that a lot of times you play with your friends now. It's like, as technology has advanced, it's allowed you to do that. As you play Xbox, you can play Xbox Live, you join parties, get to talk with all your friends, you all get to play the games and have a good time. It's like going out to hang out on a Saturday, Friday night, but you're just sitting in your living room comfortable, so it's nice to do that. Same for like on the computer, like Skype, it's amazing. You just get to play a game on the computer. You can all join up and play, but you can all sign into Skype and be talking on the chat together. So it's a really good time to be able to just talk with all your friends and to just, like, have a good time.
It seems to me a lot of times when I've seen people play is that a large part of it is just that playing, just having fun, the joy of playing.
That is very much a part of it. It's fun to just sit down and to play and to get good at it and to, like, to be the best that you can be and to be able to, like, beat other people and to have that, like, competitive thing or just to enjoy having that. It's just like when you're younger, you just, like, grab, like, a remote control car and you just ride it around. And it's just a blast to have that. It's the same with this, and video games are, enjoyed by all ages, and they always have been. And it's just something that is fun and you can enjoy at any time.
So, what are the things that affect your mood as you go throughout your day?
Well, stupid little things affect my mood throughout the day because no matter how hard you try to prevent these things from happening, they will always come back and haunt you.
So, how do you react to the little things? What about them affects you?
Well, when these stupid little things happen to me, I show three expressions. I get mad. I'm mad. I get annoyed. I'm annoyed. Or even get awkward if it's really that bad. I'm awkward. Once you experience these stupid little things that happen to you on a day-by-day basis, you learn to overcome them by, like, say, if you fall or trip or whatever, you get back up and you just show no remorse and walk away from it.
Can you give me some examples of the little bad things that happen to you during the day?
Well, there are many different examples that could get you mad on a day-by-day basis. For example, dropping food you just bought on the ground. Dropping a drink that you just bought on the ground. Then there's the worst ones that make you feel really awkward, like tripping up and down stairs if someone's watching you. Thinking that someone's waving at you, but they're really not. And the worst one is when you give someone a handshake and they don't know how to give you a handshake back, so it's just wicked awkward and you just feel weird. And stupid.
Hey, what's up, dude?
Hey, man.
Catch you around, man. Do you think it's funny when you see other things happening to people?
Personally, I think it's hilarious when people experience these awkward moments, because when their face gets puffy red, it just makes me laugh because it makes me bring back memories how I was awkward. And I overcome those awkward moments, so it makes me feel pretty accomplished. Idiot.
Hey, man. So you've mentioned that you overcame those little bad things and how you just moved on. You want to explain what that means?
Well, as I said before, my three expressions was when I was mad. I used to get mad and all puffy red and I just looked like an idiot. So after the billionth time, I just realized to laugh about it and just walk away from it, because it only takes up a minute of time and you just don't realize if it happened ever again. The second one's when I'm annoyed. Same thing, after the billionth time, I don't know, it just happens for like a minute. You just walk away from me, you just don't really care after that, because you're not going to think about it the next day, so it's not really a big deal. My third expression is the awkwardness that happens. I'm not really a big fan of it because I don't like feeling awkward, but like I'm the type of person that just doesn't care what you think of me. If you like me, you like me. If you don't, you don't. That's just how I look at it. But if you overcome the awkwardness, you just get back up. Whatever, just walk away from it, because you never think about it again. Who cares? The next day, you just go on with your life and you just don't give a shit.
So when these little bad things happen to other people, what you would say to them is that those little things aren't important. It doesn't shape who you are, like define who and what you'll do.
Exactly, because I don't know, if I have a kid or whatever, if I have kids, I'm just going to tell them straight up. Don't think about it. Don't care what anyone thinks of you. Be yourself. Do whatever you want. Don't be a follower. Be a leader. And just have fun.
Thanks for tuning in this week's episode of This American Life. I hope you have a better understanding of things that can affect your attitude and how those things affect the way you live your life. I'm your host, Jacob Bancroft, speaking. Tune in next week for a brand new episode.